I tell ya, these community polls never cease to surprise me. I was expecting G4 to win the last community poll because of how often you guys request it, but I was shocked to find that it didn't even make the top 3. And I even ran this poll for a week, which is longer than I usually run them for. So which subject actually ended up winning? Nick Music. Yeah. For some reason, you all wanted a history video about Nick Music, a little-known network that I hardly see anyone mention, more than a video about G4, a network that is far more well-known and that, after my Tech TV video a couple years ago, seemingly every other one of you wanted to see covered on this channel. Funny how things work out sometimes. But hey, Medora is all about the lesser-known, or at least lesser-discussed, TV brands. It's what started this channel. So having said that, it makes sense that Nick Music would be the first one of the 3 winning community poll subjects I'd cover. I had no idea Nick Music even existed until a couple months ago, so of course I never watched it when I was younger. In fact, I still have yet to actually watch the network. But as it turns out, there's much more to this channel than I thought at first. So let me tell you all about it. As the name suggests, Nick Music focuses mostly on, well, music. It's like a teen version of MTV, with music videos and music-related content. However, the network wasn't always associated with Nickelodeon. In fact, it started life on May 1st, 2002, as a channel associated with MTV, MTV Hits. The network took its name from MTV's pop music show, MTV Hits, and it aired much of the same music. In December 2005, MTV Hits introduced a feature called My Playlist Month, where viewers would submit playlists to the MTV Hits website, and then those playlists would be aired on the network. This eventually evolved into another feature called Playlistism. Yes, that was the actual name. In which the past playlists featured on Playlist Month would be aired along with playlists from the recently launched MTVU and other playlists, often themed by artist. Playlistism kept running, but kept fading away over the passing years, and it was eventually discontinued in 2011. On March 26th of the following year, MTV Hits got a brand refresh to align it with the rest of MTV, which had been refreshed 2 years prior. However, shortly after this, the MTV Digital Network suite that it was a part of began being rebranded entirely. Hits' sister network, MTV Jam, which had been launched on the same day as MTV Hits, was rebranded in 2015 as BET Jam, and MTV Hits held out for another year before being rebranded as Nick Music on September 9th, 2016. Though a few of the blocks from MTV Hits were carried over to Nick Music, the rest of the rebranded network was new. Since Teen Nick Top 10 ended in 2018, Nick Music airs no official shows. Instead, it airs music videos in different blocks throughout the day, including Bumpin' Beats, Crushworthy, The Hit List, Videos We Heart, Pop Playback, Weekend Vibes, Nick Mix, and Fresh Faces. In this way, it very much stands out from the other Nickelodeon networks. In fact, it doesn't feel much like a Nickelodeon network at all, and that's because, though it carries the Nickelodeon branding, it is still very much an MTV network at heart. I think Viacom could have found a better, more effective, and creative way to fuse the two brands together. Imagine if Nick Music was a channel that was very similar to classic MTV, but instead of cartoons like The Brothers Grunt and Beavis and Butthead airing with and between music videos, it was Nickelodeon cartoons airing. Perhaps they could have reworked some Nicktoons so that the characters could provide snappy and comedic commentary on the music videos like in Beavis and Butthead. I don't know about you, but that seems pretty awesome to me. Alas though, that seems unlikely to happen. Instead, we have an MTV network merely wearing the skin of a Nickelodeon network. How disappointing. I don't know if it will last much longer given the gradual switch to digital with Paramount Plus, but though it will be a bit of a shame when Nick Music eventually kicks the bucket, frankly, we won't be missing much. Let me know in the comments. How familiar are you with this network? Do you watch it or enjoy it? Anyway, thanks for watching. And as always, stay tuned.